wrestling fans, welcome to Mid-Atlantic Championship Wrestling, television's most exciting hour. And what a week it's been. Already the Jim Crockett Senior Memorial Cup Tag Team Tournament is now history. The winner of the first cup and the $1 million, the Road Warriors, as they defeated in the final match the team of Magnum TA and Ronnie Garvin, as Ronnie Garvin re-injured his hand during that match. An exciting hour in store for all of you fans this week. We're going to see a World TV title match with the champion Arn Anderson putting his title on the line. Also, the World Tag Team Champions will be here. The National Tag Team, or the National Champion, Tully Blanchard, and also the World Champion, Nature Boy Ric Flair, will be talking with him. Speaking of talking, right now, here's the man.
And I got a lot of talking to do, okay?
The World Tag Team Champion.
That's right. Road Warriors, we didn't win the cup, but you didn't beat the Midnight Express. We're still the World Tag Team Champions. The World Tag Team title is still the most prestigious title for a wrestling team, and the World Tag Team Champions still make more money than any team in professional wrestling. So, Road Warriors, you haven't proved a thing, and we're still looking for you. And you know somebody else we got to prove things to? Dusty Rhodes and Magnum TA, America's team, the American dream, the American heartthrob. You think you're really something, you come out here and you talk a great team, but when it comes time to get in the ring and prove it, I don't see you doing it too often. Well, let me tell you something. Everybody thought the Rock and Roll Express were unbeatable, and we beat them. Everybody thought the Road Warriors were the team capable of taking us out, and they haven't pinned the Midnight Express. And Dusty and Magnum, you're the last team that everybody all across the country thinks is unbeatable. And we're going to show you just how bogus you really are. We're going to prove to everybody, including that bunch of welfare cases that you call fans that look up to you, that the Midnight Express and Jim Cornette are the cream of the crop in professional wrestling, and you are a bunch of scum, a bunch of trash. And Dusty, I wish your daddy was here so I could use my tax money to stamp his welfare card and his food stamps and send him on his way.
Jim Cornette, the manager of the World Tag Team Champions, Midnight Express fans, we're about ready with action. Let's go to the ring now. We're going to see an action right here. Chief Wahoo McDaniel, let's go to the ring. And here's my partner, Johnny Weaver. And Johnny, what a rousing way to get the hour started.
That certainly was, Cornette. Really putting out a lot of heated words at a lot of great teams there, Bob. Sometimes you bite off more than you can chew. America's team, the Road Warrior, the Rock and Roll Express, and he has the World Tag Team Champions. And in the ring, the legendary Chief Wahoo McDaniel. And speak of Wahoo, quickly right now, the thing that comes to your mind is Gorgeous Jimmy Garvin and Precious. And that big chops on his opponent, Mike Samani.
Mike Samani, yeah. And Johnny, he had Samani against the ropes, and he's going to finish him off in quick order.
And those big chops take their toll again as the Big Chief. Nobody chops as hard as Wahoo. We're going to... There's the Chief leaving the ring. That great win for Chief Wahoo McDaniel.
Fans, with me right now, Tony Schiavone. Tony, we mentioned that the big night, of course, is now history. The Jim Crockett Senior Memorial Tag Team Tournament, the Memorial Cup Tag Team Tournament is history. What a great night it was. Now, you were in New Orleans. Tell us about that night, Tony, and about New Orleans.
Another page, Bob, in wrestling history has been turned as the Jim Crockett Senior Memorial Cup is over. But we want to thank the city of New Orleans, the mayor of New Orleans, the Hyatt Regency for great accommodations. It certainly was a night that none of us will ever forget. And, of course, the Road Warriors, the team that came away with the big prize. And, Bob, within 30 days, we're going to name the site for the 1987 Jim Crockett Senior Memorial Cup
Fantastic.
Tournament. That'll come within the next 30 days. So, fans, you want to stay tuned right here. And, Bob, I think we have some highlights we want to show the fans from the tournament.
We do. And, fans, let's watch them right here. Highlights of the big night. Tony, looking at that, you can just feel the excitement of the night.
What a great night, but most of all, we want to thank the fans. Fans from 40 states and several foreign countries in attendance at the Superdome. Fans, you're what make us great. And once again, another great night. Thanks to all the fans who came out for the Jim Crockett Senior Memorial Cup. Bob, just another outstanding day of professional wrestling.
And Tony, as you say, I'm already looking forward to 1987.
So am I, and I'm sure the fans are also. Thanks again.
All right, fans, ready for more action now as the national champion is in the ring. Let's go to the ring, and here he is. There's the belt around the waist of the champion, Mr. Tully Blanchard. And Johnny, of course, he's got Mr. James J. Dillon over there in that corner with him.
And they were an intricate part of that Jim Crockett Senior Memorial Cup. What a night that was, Bob. What great talent in that film clip, boy. You had the cream of the crop there.
Absolutely, Johnny. The top wrestlers in the world, all of them assembled right there for that one big night. And one of them in the ring right now in the person of the national champion, Tully Blanchard. His opponent is Rocky Knuckle. Johnny, there's a lot been coming down between this champion in the ring, between another champion, our television champion, and a third champion, our world champion. We're talking about Ric Flair and what the three of them have been doing, Johnny.
The three horsemen, you know, they're... You can't imagine what they'll come up with. But when you take Blanchard right here, the national champion, Bob, this man, there's very few times that he hasn't had a belt around his waist. Held the TV title, longest reign in history. Then held a U.S. title. Look at it. Canoodle gets caught from behind by Blanchard.
Well, Canoodle had Tully Blanchard to the mat, and James J. Dillon, you got a good look at it. And Dillon just popped him right in the face.
Tully Bob off the top. Caught Canoodle in the back. Looks like he's going for the slingshot. Slingshot suplex. And that should put him away.
The favorite move of the champion, Tully Blanchard. And Johnny Weaver, when he slingshots the opponent off of the ropes, gets him high in the air with that force when he pounds him to the mat. That's all she wrote. And watch it here in slow motion.
We see the pin right here in slow motion. The winner of the match, the national heavyweight champion, and one of the three horsemen, Tully Blanchard.
Fans, with me right now, here is the world television champion, of course, Arn Anderson. And Arn, you,
Bob,
the world champion, the national champion, all of you have been, you've been sort of trying to hurt guys, Arn.
What you've been doing so much is a case of Rocky Knuckle overmatching himself against the national champion coming in here, Tully. I'll tell you what we've done, Bob Cottle. We've just showed guys like Ricky Morton exactly the pain that Dusty Rhodes has felt, exactly the pain that Garvin's felt, the pain that Sam Houston's felt. Anytime you try to instigate or intervene into what the three horsemen are accomplishing all across this great country of ours, that's what happened to you. Ricky Morton, all you were was a candy gram to the rest of the country, the rest of any man that puts a pair of tights or a pair of knee pads on. That's what he's got to expect. Tell him about it, Tully.
You know, I tell you, you just saw an example. Somebody that I may have took a little bit lightly, who got a little bit uppity in the ring and had to be slapped down. And that's just what I did, because I can turn on like that, baby. Turn on like that. Anybody the three horsemen take lightly, we can turn on and slap down and show them the dirt that they are. Ricky Morton, you look in the mirror, you think about it. Dusty Rhodes, you look at him, you think about it. Anybody doesn't think the three horsemen are where it's at, you got another thing coming.
All right, fans, now back to the ring. We're ready with action in the ring. And here's
Jim Cornette.
Ladies
and gentlemen, when you talk about tag team wrestling, these men are still the best there is. Loverboy Dennis and beautiful Bobby, the Midnight Express.
and two more champions in the ring now. The World Tag Team Champions of Midnight Express, George South, Ron Rossi across the way. And Johnny, Jim Cornette has every right to be proud of these two young men. They have just accomplished a tremendous amount of the time that they've been champions. They've wrestled quite often, and they've defeated everybody that they've met.
He may not have led him to the Jim Crockett Memorial Cup, but he's led him to that World Tag Team Championship. I don't know. He's really biting off a lot. He's hollering now about America's team. That's and right. Their Warriors. And boy, that's a tall company to be challenging Cornette. He's got a fantastic team, though, here in beautiful Bobby and Loverboy Dennis. You watch this. Oh, teamwork. Yes, sir.
And Rossi felt the full impact of that as he was lifted high to the air and slammed hard to the mat. Rossi just flat out as beautiful Bobby caught him full force, Johnny.
And there's the World Tag Team Champions of Midnight Express. Winners, once more. We're going to see it again in slow motion as teamwork together. Bobby has dropped all his weight across Rossi, and right here he hooks the leg. The winner's the World Tag Team Champions of Midnight Express.
Fans, the American Dream, one half of America's team, Dusty Rhodes and Baby Doll. Dusty.
You know, first of all, there's a lot of serious things going on around this country right now, and I don't know what's got into Ric Flair, but I'm going to get that just a little later. Midnight Express put the name on the line for America's team, Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream. At Magnum TA, let me tell you something, Jimmy Cornette. You out here knocking somebody very, very dear to me when you're talking about my old man, because he's up there somewhere looking down at the American Dream right now, and it ain't real funny, you understand? The other thing, you know, you asked me before we came on what I think of the Midnight Express. Well, I kind of picture them sitting around Jimmy Cornette's mama's table, eating dinner, all three of them wearing pantyhose, you understand? Can you figure that sight out right there? That's what I think of you. The only reason you're the World's Tag Team Champions, that somewhere down the line when the Rock and Roll Express had their backs turned, Jim Cornette, the referee didn't see you one time. That's the reason you're going to lose the titles of Magnum T.A., America's Team, and Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream. Nature Boy, Ric Flair, Tully Blanchard, and Iron Anderson, and James J. Dillon. The Rock and Roll Express. Let me tell you what happened. There was a six-man elimination tournament. The last man left was Ricky Martin and the Nature Boy, Ric Flair. And I'm going to show you right here, right now, in a few seconds, what took place, what transpired, and what it's all about. See me getting out of the ring right there. Ricky Martin and Nature Boy, Ric Flair, capacity crowd right here. Flair wanted this kid, called him out, and right here you're gonna see one of the greatest, not even, I ain't calling it upset. I'm gonna call it whooping. Honey whoopings you ever seen in the history of wrestling. This is the Nature Boy. This is the champion of the world. There is no other. He is the world's heavyweight champion. Nature Boy, Ric Flair, right here, Ricky Martin and him going toe to toe. The other men have been eliminated. It's between these two men. Somewhere down the line, you got to leave it between these two men, Ric Flair. Whatever's got in you, will your pride's gone? Will your respect is gone? I have no idea. But right here, you see Ricky Martin taking all Ric Flair has to dish out right here. Going into the turnbuckle right here, you're going to see history in the making. One, two, three. Ricky Martin defeated the world's heavyweight champion, Ric Flair. Right there on the way to the dressing room, jubilant. Going back stunned, look at Iron Anderson. His usual goofy look on his face, stunned. Right here going through the curtain into a dressing room where Ricky Martin and Robert were. Right here you see J.J. Dillon, every one of them, thugs, vengeance, terrorists, thugs in the night, a pre-planned attack right here. You see him stomping here, but I want to watch this. Ric Flair taking Ricky Martin's face right here. Look at your screen, look at the floor, as part of this man's face is actually put on that floor right there by the Nature Boy, Ric Flair. This got to stop somewhere down the line. This kid now, maybe scarred for life, Ric Flair. You can talk about all you want to talk about, but when you're talking about Ricky Martin, Dusty Rhodes, Rock and Roll, Magnum T.A., you want to try to scar somebody's face, you're going to get a true foe. He won't take this lying down. America won't take this lying down. Dues are going to be paid in a very, very short time.
The American Dream, Dusty Rhodes fans, and Baby Doll. All right, fans, right here, the manager of the World Tag
Been
Team
going to
Champions.
Matt Taylor, huh, Bob? Starting
Express.
To look sharp.
And, man, I tell you, we saw him up there. You're talking about sharp. Those two guys of yours, they were really sharp.
They're sharp as a tack. They're the World Tag Team Champions, regardless of what happened in the Cup. Nobody beat us in that tournament. We're still the World Tag Team Champions. We still make more money than any tag team at professional wrestling, and that's all that counts. And there's nobody that's going to take those belts off from around our waist. You know, Ricky Morton's never looked better since Slick Rick gave him that little facial. I really enjoyed watching that. That was perfectly called for. I called for it, and a whole lot of sensible people called for it. Rock and Roll Express, you suffered through some bad times. Road Warriors, Precious Paul, if I were you, I'd take a real good careful look at my investment and see just exactly what kind of adjustments need to be made, because the Midnight Express are going to show the whole world that the Road Warriors are not unbeatable. And one more team is concerning me right now. You know, Dusty Rhodes and Magnum TA, they come out all over the country on national television, and they make a lot of claims. They claim they're America's team. Why aren't we America's team? We were born in America. We're just as American as they are. They claim they're the greatest duo that ever stepped foot in a wrestling ring. But let me tell you this, Dusty and Magnum, when it comes time for you to get in the ring and prove that you're the greatest, I don't see them doing it too often. They do a lot of interviews. They pal around a lot. I know they go ride their motorcycles and their horses and all that stuff together, but they don't get in the ring together a lot. Maybe it's because they figure they got all the people bluffed. They got them talked into thinking they're one of the greatest teams, but they don't want to prove it in the ring. Well, Dusty, for your information, for one thing, you're a modern-day cowboy, right? Well, if you go outside and look on the street, you don't see too many hitching posts, and you don't see a lot of watering troughs. And Magnum, I noticed you ride your motorcycle around. You got your nice little leather jacket on. You got your wallet chain in your back pocket. The chain is worth more than what's in the wallet. Let me tell you both something. I don't agree with you philosophically. I don't like you personally. I don't like you professionally. And the Midnight Express is going to show just how much displeasure I got with you two by beating you right in the middle of the ring and proving that you're nothing but another team that's going down to the Midnight Express. People with class, people with dignity, look up to myself and the Express. A bunch of welfare cases standing in line look up to you.
All right, fans, with us right now, here's the man with the hands of stone, Ronnie Garvin. Garvin, Ronnie, you re-injured that hand, though, in a match, and what a big match it was. There was $1 million on the line. The opponent, the Road Warriors.
Well, it was the greatest wrestling event I ever participated in, and we made it to the final, and I'm very proud to say that Magnum and I did a very good job. And if it wouldn't have been for my hand, you know, when I threw that last right hand, when you hurt, you just cannot compete at your level, at your 100% level. But we did good, and I'm not bitter about it. I'm just hurt. We didn't win $1 million. We didn't win the Cup. And I'd like to congratulate the Road Warriors. After all, we're fighting for $1 million, and everybody was on their own. And it's water under the bridge in 1986. There's plenty to do and plenty to go after.
Well, a guy came back here last week after being gone for a couple of weeks. Let's see what happened to him. I'm talking about Jimmy Valiant, Ronnie. And, of course, you're well aware of what happened to him. Let's watch it right here. Here is Paul Jones, Shaska, in the ring. And Shaska's holding up that hair, which he had cut several weeks ago from Jimmy Valiant.
Well, you know, I don't really know exactly what happened to Piers Watley. You know, obviously money has got a lot to do with what happened.
Watch right here. They're trying to cut the hair of George South now after they've defeated him.
I'm going to tell you, there's a lot of things happening around
here. Here comes the boogeyman.
The boogeyman is going to come back. He's going to take that land down. He's not going to just turn his back and walk away from this. You know, and I'm going to give a warning to Piers Watley. I know Jimmy Valiant. He's a good friend of mine.
But it's three against one right here.
It's usually the situation. You know, I've had the same thing happen to me. You know, we're talking about J.J. Dillon and everybody, 3-on-1, 2-on-1. And this is only going to last so long. Believe me, things are going to happen. And this is just a warning. This is a warning, guys. Things are going to happen. People are going to get hurt. They've already been hurt. You cannot go on and on and on and keep doing things like that. You know, and I'm going to tell you, I blame Tully Blanchard for not being able to compete in the Cup at 100%. I blamed J.J. Dillon, Arn Anderson, the Three Horsemen, and even Ric Flair, because I know deep down Ric Flair's in the back of all that. And I'm going to tell you what they did to Ricky Morton. It's not going to go unpunished. You cannot just go on pushing people around, slapping people around, breaking the rules, not caring about people's feelings. Somebody's going to come back. Somebody's going to come back strong, and you're looking at one of them. Risky business, boy. Remember that.
All right, Ronnie Garvin. Now, fans, let's go back to the ring and more action. And into the ring, the Rock and Roll Express. But Johnny Weaver, you will notice that Ricky Morton is not even dressed in his wrestling tights, and you saw one whole side of his face completely bandaged. And that, of course, came at the hands of Ric Flair.
That was a good shot right there we got of Ricky. Maybe we can get another close-up. It's really a mess, his face. You see the evidence of that attack of really Bob Four on two, because Jay Dillon was right in there with three arms. Look at that. Yeah. There's a great shot, guys. Boy, they really messed up his face.
Vernon Deaton and Tony Zane across the ring as Robert Gibson now is in. Johnny, looks like he's going to be taking on two men during this match while his partner is outside.
Robert Gibson in the ring. There's another shot. Boy, really just a horrible mess. The left side there of Ricky's face. We saw Flair grind that face into the concrete floor of that dressing room, Bob. A really uncalled for situation because the match was already over. They were already back to the locker room. And three horsemen with Dillon, four on two, barged in there once again and attacked two men. And that's awful odds to have to overcome, Bob.
It sure is. And it had to be done. Ric Flair had to do it, and he had to do it on purpose. He was trying to do to Robert Gibson exactly what he did, Johnny. And there again, fans, you got to look at it. And he's got to be in pain. And just how long it's going to affect him and affect his wrestling, Johnny, is hard to tell.
No, he's got too much of a heart for it to affect his wrestling. He's letting Robert carry the load tonight, but you can be sure that he's going to be in wrestling tights. That won't hold the likes of Ricky Morton down. Here's Robert really opening up now on Vernon Deaton.
Or like Dusty Rhodes said, he could be scarred for life from that too, Johnny.
It's a serious, you can see the evidence. It's a serious face injury there, but I'm sure it's not going to take anything. In fact, it's going to probably put a little more emphasis in the matches that he has anytime he can meet Flair or Tully or Arn Anderson. But he's a great world champion, tag team champion. Probably will be again many times. What a shot, Bob. His face is really burnt up from that concrete burn. And of course,
Flair just kept rubbing it and digging it and pushing it into the concrete and sliding it across that concrete time after time after time, Johnny.
And that bandage, of course, over almost all the left side of his face. Just an incredible incident.
Gibson fighting now off of the ropes as he was backed into him.
Robert Gibson, his partner, in the ring in action. Step over, toe hold, reverse the bridge. And Ricky knows it's all over. And Ricky knows it's all over. A great win for Robert Gibson. There with Ricky, another shot of that face. Ooh. We're going to see it in slow motion. Big high backdrop. He really gets Bernadine high in the air, which stuns Deaton. He's going to step in with that step over toe hold. You'll see him spin on it, Bob, reverse it.
What he does that, the shoulders are a little mat for the count of three, and it's all over. With Robert Gibson, our winner, and fans, will be back for that more action right after we take this brief timeout. fans of Rock and Roll Express, Ricky Morton. Earlier we saw Ric Flair and what he did to you, Rick. Now we see the results.
That's right. I want Tully Blanchard. I want Arn Anderson and J.J. Dillon, and especially you, Ric Flair, to take a good look at my face, baby, because you're going to see a lot of it. Now, I don't care what it takes or what extreme that the Rock and Roll Express has to go to. We're going to show you what we're really made out of. You know, what it all boils down to is jealousy. Jealousy, Ric Flair, because rock and roll is here to stay. Now, you can say one thing. Ric Flair, NWA World Heavyweight Champion. But, baby, you better put it down now as the former NWA World Heavyweight Champion, because this bedside, me and you, Ric Flair, we're gonna get it all, baby. The sky is the limit. I'm coming to take what means more to you, Ric Flair, than life itself. That's that big belt that you wear around your waist. You say, in order to be the man, you've got to beat the man, and I've done it. I beat you, Ric Flair, right there in the middle of the ring. It's not over, baby. Every dog has got his day. Ric Flair, yours is just right around the corner. And for you, Tully Blanchard and Arn Anderson, wait till the Rock and Roll Express gets a hold of you, brother. We're coming after you with everything we got. American Dream is right behind the Rock and Roll Express, and we're coming to do some damage. Ric Flair, I don't care what it takes, brother. You belong to me. You belong to the Rock and Roll Express, and you belong to all these nice people. I'm gonna take that world belt from you.
Fans, here he is, the World Heavyweight Champion, Nature Boy Ric Flair with that championship belt. Why in the world will you do what you did to the face of Ricky Morton?
Bob Caudle, it's got to be an inspiration not only to you, but to all the wrestling fans out there to have a good-looking man on this screen after we all just saw. It's a cold, cold world out there, isn't it, Punk? Huh? Think about it, Punk. You're going to carry that scar the rest of your life. And to answer your question, Bob Connell, I did that to him because I wanted to. You understand that? Nobody crosses the line in the no man's land, which is my backyard, especially when I'm standing with the infamous James J. Dillon at my side and the other two horsemen. I'm talking about the World Television Champion and the National Heavyweight Champion, Arn Anderson and Tully Blanchard. And as I said, it's a cold, cold world. How about that, Punk? Hey, Punk, you gotta be the ugliest human being on the face of this earth. And yes, you're right. Tell the whole world the contracts are signed. You got a shot at the big gold. You got a shot now at the world's champion. And if you walk that aisle looking like you do right now, you're more man than I give you credit for, because next time around, Punk, I'm gonna hurt you real bad. And if you think that face hurts, ask Dusty Rhodes, ask Big Dust what it felt like when they carried him out on a stretcher with a broken leg. That hurts real bad. And Morton, if you show up to wrestle me, I'm guaranteeing you more violence than you've ever seen or felt in your entire wrestling career. How about it, girls? Let's start hollering, Space Mountain, not rock and roll. Woo!
A World Heavyweight Champion, Nature Boy Ric Flair. flamboyant entrance for this man, gorgeous Jimmy Garvin, as he gets ready here to do battle
with Todd Bradford. Gorgeous Jimmy going up against a big, good-looking athlete, Todd Bradford. And this could be a real test for Gorgeous Jimmy. We've seen him with some great victories here.
Johnny, you'll notice, and I'm sure all the fans notice, that Precious was not down there. She didn't go into the ring with Garvin. She is not here, I understand. She's off on her shopping spree. She's off spending some of that money he's been making.
Well, that's the way we heard the story, but Bob, maybe she's not here because Chief Wahoo McDaniels is here. And you know, it wasn't long ago she sprayed his face full of that whatever she's got in that spray can, and the result was Wahoo taking some lumps from Gorgeous Jimmy. So they had called and they wanted to get the Chief here. Well, the Chief's here, and now we don't see Precious.
That's right. Garvin in that headlock, into the corner. Boy, he can work you over in the corner. He's doing that too right here.
By the reversal, by the youngster. What an experience right there. Garvin quickly behind him. This could be it. And a win for Gorgeous Jimmy Garvin. He found an opening, and he took advantage of it. We're going to see it in slow motion as Garvin, Gorgeous Jimmy, wins another one. A fine reversal by the youngster, but he got over anxious, charged that corner, nothing there but turnbuckle, and the quickness of Jimmy Garvin right behind him with a cradle, and the shoulders are down. Gorgeous Jimmy Garvin with another victory.
All right, fans, with us right now, here's the man with the hands of stone, Ronnie Garvin. Ronnie, that hand, and we talk about it being of stone, but it's been giving you some problems lately. You've had it injured a couple of times, and one of the three horsemen, or the three horsemen, really started it out for you.
Well, you know, I've knocked out a lot of people. And I guess there's a lot of people around here that are scared of. They're scared of my right hand because they got a lot to lose. And I'm talking about Tully Blanchard, Arn Anderson, and Ric Flair. Now, Tully Blanchard, I want you. It's not Uncle Sam talking to you. It's Ronnie Garvin. I want you, and I'm going to get you. I'm going to have you. I'm going to get to touch your body in a manner that you're not going to like. You see, because every time I do something, this reminds me of you. Because I can deal with pain. I'm not out here crying about it. I can take it like a man because I'm in professional wrestling, and everybody knows that professional wrestling is a tough sport. People do get hurt. But when I get hurt the way I've got hurt, I don't like it. You see, because it's purposely done, 3-on-1, because you couldn't get the job done all by yourself. You cannot step as a man into that ring as a professional wrestler and hurt me or beat me or do anything, because you know I'm better than you. I've proven it to you many times. Now, you got to get the help of J.J. Dillon and Arn Anderson. Well, I'm going to take care of business the way it should be done. Perhaps I've been too nice. Perhaps I've been trying to be a real sports, a real gentleman. Well, when you deal with people like Tully Blanchard, Arn Anderson, and J.J. Dillon, and Ric Flair, you don't turn the other cheek because it don't work. Perhaps instead of using my hand, I should use a 2x4 and crush some skulls, beat some face in, and break some bones. Well, whatever I got to do, I'm going to do it. The Risky Business Boys can appear on the scene any day. And I'm talking about Risky Business. I'm talking about people getting hurt, and I'm not just talking in the wind. I'm not just making promises. I'm telling something that is going to be done, something that's going to happen in the future. Because bones do heal. But I've got a memory like an elephant, and I can do it like an elephant. We can crush people. We can put you out of wrestling for good. And I'm talking about for good.
All right, fans, Gorgeous Jimmy Garvin, I have never seen you out here without Precious. Where in the world is Precious?
Let me tell you, first of all, it's none of your stinking business, but since I'm a nice guy, I guess I'm going to let you know anyway and let all the fans know. Son of a gun, I tell you, I almost feel naked out here without my squeeze, but it just goes to show you what kind of gentleman Gorgeous Jimmy Garvin is. I mean, I know you think I'm really a nice guy, but that's not it. I'm a great guy. My poor squeeze we should almost have a moment of silence for her, because do you know what? At this very moment, and for the last 5 hours, my little precious has been sitting out there at that Sturgeon Falls reservation waiting for that Wahoo McDaniel to show up and sign that contract. Yes, it's the truth, ladies and gentlemen. That poor girl's been out there waiting, and she just ran up to a phone booth about 10 miles up the road, just talked to me, said she wasn't going to be able to be here today, and it's just a crying shame. But that just goes to show you what a devoted individual she is and what a nice person she is, too. But I'm going to keep the people updated. I think she's going to be camping out there for tonight. So anybody, if you want to say a little prayer for her, she's going to be out in the wilderness waiting for that no-good-for-nothing Indian to come home to that awful reservation. Poor thing.
Gorgeous Jimmy Garvin. And fans, we're going to see a match right now for the World Television title as the champion, Arn Anderson, puts it on the line, Johnny Weaver.
And Bobby, he got a hand of door this time. He defended that belt on TV many, many times. But then in this match, he has moved up the ladder some, because Don Cornuto is one of the top wrestlers in the United States, was a top amateur, and of course, two-time World Tag Team Champion. So Arn Anderson, you finally moved up and put it up against some real good competition.
Yes, sirree, should be a whale of a match. Johnny, and by the way, I think we should mention here that this is a match for time remaining for the television title.
Time remaining in the program, this match will go far. And of course, you know, we asked our way, how about putting that belt up? Let's see it against the Magnums and the Dusties. Then go up to Cornuto, and let's see how this one comes out.
Fans, remember, you're watching NWA Pro Wrestling, the very finest in professional wrestling. And boy, have we had the champions here tonight, Johnny.
And Arn quickly to the ropes. This is a fine counter reversal by Cornuto. Two top heavyweights going right at it, right ahead on at each other. Of course, Arn Anderson, a member of those three horsemen. And Bob, they've really got some controversy going about their deeds outside the ring, let alone inside.
You know, and they, when you look at who they've got after them, I tell you, they got to be looking over their shoulder. If I were Ric Flair, the way Ricky Morton is right now, Johnny, I would never even turn my back to anybody. Ricky Morton, and who can blame him? The way Ric Flair has scarred him up. What you got Ronnie Garvin in that hand of his.
And of course, Dusty's broken leg in the past. The three horsemen, they each one have a belt around their waist, a major title.
Johnny, that's a very important point. Not only a title, but a major title. The World Heavyweight Championship, the National Heavyweight Championship, and the World Television title all around the waist of those three.
And we heard from Ricky Morton, we heard from Ric Flair, both sides of the story. I think what it did, Bob, it gave Ricky Morton a little more incentive. And sometimes that's the incentive that you need, that's a difference in the match. Because he is really uptight about what happened to him. And I know he's going to really go in there with everything he's got.
Cornuto with a headlock, knocked up twice by Arn Anderson. Cornuto, who is a big one, and he's a strong, rough, tough individual. Johnny, as you mentioned, he's going to give Arn Anderson a real go for it.
And also, Bob, with the Road Warriors and America's team after Jim Cornette, I think he'll have a few sleepless nights coming up. Things are really happening. They're really popping.
And, Johnny, I think we ought to send along our congratulations, too, to the Road Warriors. They're the Road Warriors and Paul Ellering now, three very wealthy young men after having won that Jim Crockett Senior Memorial Cup Tag Team Tournament and that check for $1 million.
But I know it doesn't set well with them, of Cornette shooting off his mouth like he is.
Cornuto with Anderson high to the air, and he suplexed him hard to the mat. Can he pin him right
here? This could
be
it right here, Bob. The World Television Champion stays alive, kicked out on the count of two. But he looks like he's worn down.
He looks groggy, Johnny.
This match for the remaining time of this program, and they're really getting out with it. And here's Arn trying to fight back. Stops Cornuto some.
Cornuto in the corner on the ropes, trying to catch a breath. Anderson right on top of him with those lefts and rights.
They don't want to leave out the situation of Jimmy Valiant saying the Boogie Woogie Man with Chasco Riley. They're uptight again against Paul Jones. And of course, gorgeous Jimmy Garvin is about to get what he wanted, the big chief, Wahoo McDaniels.
Johnny, at least that's what he says he wants, is the big chief. We're going to see how much he wants him when he gets hold of Wahoo.
Well, we didn't see Precious around here tonight. We didn't see Wahoo.
Well, they ran right into the referee there, Johnny.
Arn trying to keep the leverage on this hole so he can keep Canoodle tied up.
Still with the arm, it's still the pressure. And oh, the referee again trying to open up that fist of Don Canoodle.
But Arn very wisely taking advantage of the situation, regains the leverage and has Canoodle off his feet. That's where he wants to have him.
Down goes Canoodle from that block. But Johnny, this is the match that we thought it would be. We knew that Don Canoodle was really going to test Arn Anderson.
Oh,
and he's more than testing him.
Sleeper bomb! That brings everybody out of their seat. Arn Anderson called the sleeper hold. Center of the ring. He might have it right here.
We might have a new television champion as Don Canoodle has got the champion in the sleeper, and already he's down to one knee.
And look at his eyes. He's really glazed, trying to struggle, but Canoodle, a big man too, holding on.
Canoodle still putting the pressure on the sleeper.
Arn Wiltz, but Wiltz under the ropes.
When he fell face However, forward, right into the ropes, Johnny.
He won't recover too quickly from that. Canoodle's got to stay right on him. And a little sting has been taken out of the punches of the champion now. Canoodle in. Could this be a vertical suplex? He's got him up, and he gets it.
And the crowd loving it. They like every blow that Canoodle lands on Arn Anderson, but look how smart he is. The Andersons always know where they are in the ring, Johnny.
And he found an opening, and he gets Canoodle out to the concrete floor, and that'll give him a little time to recuperate from the sleeper and the other beating he's been taking. Of course, he's in great condition, and he's going to fall out and try to do some more damage to Canoodle. The world TV champion, and acting again like he's the three horsemen, doing that damage on the outside of the ring.
Here's Don Canoodle now walking around. That's wise on his part. And as they continue to go at it, we've got 30 seconds remaining in the program. Fans, remember,
Canoodle on the outside trying to make an effort to get back into the ring. He's been thwarted by the World Tag Team Champion. Listen to our crowd with a go down, go chip.
Mid-Atlantic Championship Wrestling is a presentation of the JCP Sports Network and has been furnished to the station for broadcast at this time in exchange for commercial consideration.
Less than 20 seconds, 15 seconds now remaining. He's got him rolled up.
Over, saved again by the rope. Canoodle continues his attack.